It's happening so fast now, I almost can feel myself changing. It's happening by the hour. I'm sitting here, feeling like I'm not the same person who got out of my bed this morning. My God. Ivo, I feel like I'm changing by the microsecond. These downloads are coming fast and furious and I'm changing so quickly I don't recognize myself sometimes. Ivo, that is good, my love, as you are not who you thought you were. Me, my reaction to everything is cracking wide open. I put up the videos about today's lesson, becoming more spiritual, and the one recognizing I have an alien consciousness. Everything is different. I'm even able to express myself more succinctly. There was a guy going around in Toronto asking so-called compassionate Canadians about Trump's getting the COVID virus. These two women were answering and the one declared herself to be such a nice person and she doesn't like to speak badly of anyone, but hey, apparently when push comes to shove, she'll grab the knife. She said, he deserves it. He deserves to be sick with COVID. A 74-year-old man, who claims to have COVID-19 and she says he deserves it. So he might die. Really? You want that on your head? What do you deserve for saying that, honey? Wishing someone death. Your actions speak louder than your superficial view of yourself. You don't have me convinced you're so nice. My response to this video was this, Trump doesn't have the virus. He's playing a political card. Probably the ace that was up his sleeve all along. As far as Canadians being compassionate, stop with the nationalism. I resent your defining how someone in BC behaves by my behavior and vice versa. We're all individuals, each of us have to take responsibility for the way we think about and treat others. Nationalism is egotism. You're a Canadian and you see images of Terry Fox, Michael J. Fox and Celine Dion, and you can say, yeah, I'm like them. As if. This is association and you can't substantiate it at all. Yes, Athena, thank you. We are all one, however we're individual segments of the one because individually we have the power to change reality. That's why we live in the physical. We are God's power divided into individual units, seeking to find wholeness as one again. Welcome to Earth. That's what's going on, and that has always been what's been going on. If you're like me, and your relationships have been bitterly disappointing throughout your life, it's because you couldn't find someone to unite with to either double your God's strength, by loving each other, you're stronger together, or to start to put the Lego pieces together and reunite the whole entity of Earthling. This is why the Dark Ones have stopped you from loving other people, because united we stand, divided we fall. People grouping together, even two people grouping together, is the path to strength, power, and wholeness of the species. And that's what we're doing here. We're together, viewing this video and gaining strength in our unity. So nationalism is a false division of the species, therefore it is egotism. Countries are merely economic regions in a money game. Welcome to Monopoly. I have this desire, a strong desire, to start seeing the general thinking and behavior of the public go beyond this type of survey. We're all Canadians, so that means we're all nice? Of course we're not. If he'd have asked me, perhaps I'd have said, stop with the stupid surveys, will you? You can't classify all people living in one economic area as being of the same type of character. And I'd have walked away. Everywhere I go, the absurdity of the way people behave impacts me. This may be what you're to face, people, as you wake up. Maybe you already are. You begin to realize that you're living in the middle of insanity, and what's worse, they think of you as the crazy one. You have to be really accepting in order to walk through this peacefully. To be able to love everyone who has tormented you all your life. I'm at the point that I'm very tired of the rejection, especially by family members who believe themselves to be smarter and more sane than I am. I'm walking away. I cannot deal with the pain of seeing them make this terrible mistake. You try to help them, you try to give them your love but they're not having it. You can love all the 3Ds you want, but remember they will drag you back into their dramas. Unless you're prepared to work on yourself every time you object to anything they say or do, to scrutinize every reaction to anything they say or do, dealing with them will create pain within you. Anyone who has not dealt with their matrix mindset and brainwashing, anyone who has not risen above it to see the truth and to begin independent thinking based on soul's counsel, will cause you pain. I'm tired of pain. I've lived in it all my life. I have to let go of anyone who will cause me more pain. Life has been a terribly painful experience for me here. I know salvation is around the corner and it'll be just a while longer. If I experience pain when I'm with Ivo, then I know I legitimately have to work on it because he is my true reflection. Everyone else needs to be released in love. Sometimes letting go can be very hard. It dawned on me, as well, yesterday that the family members who believe I'm nuts don't respect me. I've discussed this with my sister. I told her I know you think I'm nuts, and she said, yes, but you're an interesting nut. This isn't a game that's going on here. This is for keeps. You're either on board with the truth or you're going to attract consequences that will wake you up. Take your pick. I hope I'm wrong, but there are many timelines to create now. There are many roads to 5D, some long, some short. Some easy, some hard. You always will attract what you need to empower you. If you are grossly disempowered by brainwashing, you will attract hard lessons. I'm getting new insights all the time. Here's one. This person said that he is very, very concerned because here Ivo's messages are so encouraging and caring, yet he read, What You Need to Know Now, and he is alarmed at the dire predictions Ivo gave in this book, which I might add, have come true now in 2020. Let me explain it to you this way. Why are you messaging me, asking me to explain to you what Ivo means when you're the one not understanding it? What onus do I have to make sure you understand? Is that a guarantee I'm to put out with all of our messages? Hey. If you don't get it, make sure you email me, so that I'm completely inundated by people with questions about anything we have said within the last 6 or so years. Fact is, if you don't understand, the onus is on you to learn. I understand perfectly what he's saying. If you don't understand, it's up to you to ask your higher self to show you. This is the real process in understanding life, to go inside to get answers and to set in motion the process of growth necessary to increase your light. If you don't get that Ivo's dire predictions are coming true now, well, you might be fated to experiencing them. Sorry for you. If you don't understand, there is a disparity in frequency. Your light quotient is too high or too low. That's why you don't get it. Those of us from higher dimensions go through a process of not understanding the way people behave here. I've studied it and I understand it, but I still don't condone it nor do I want to conform to it. There is a frequency disparity. I bridged it by lowering my frequency to become like them. Now I'm reversing the process. So are you. Ivo, my love, everything you are undergoing is a preparation for the next step. This applies to everyone. Because your lives are a process of putting one foot in front of the other and marching forward. You see it as linear right now. So be it. Sometimes you believe you are set back, but these setbacks can be advantageous if dealt with properly. Why do you think you have been set back? Because your timeline is not linear and you have actually gone back in time to another now. This is what loops are. If your timeline is in a loop, you can still relate to others who are going forward, as you call it, however you are starting this life lesson over. If you feel life has left you behind, this is why. You are in a time loop and must remove yourself from it by changing yourself sufficiently, and for you that equates to awareness, being able to put the horse before the cart, so to speak, and to not re-engage the loop. Me, lol, like John Lennon's song of Starting Over. You are starting over. You're starting over your timeline, your now moment with respect to one life lesson only, perhaps with another person and perhaps as an older person yourself. But you're starting over your timeline. Time is quantum, not linear, but we tend to explain away all the quantum aspects as just mood states. Or how many of us feel like a kid again, or feel like the first time I fell in love again. How many of us, when seeking to heal something, look back to our childhood to find out the origins of the problem. This is the timeline, and you are jumping around in it to understand how to help yourself get out of the problem and leave it behind. Ivo, I might add, my love, it is important to stay out of loops. Loops are constructed by third dimensionals in order to ensnare you into a time of your past. Your neighbor next door who was attempting to have third dimensional sexual relations is one example of this. Do not go back into the time loop, as it will set you back in so many ways. Me, he's my history, not a mystery. LOL. Ivo, in order to learn the lesson, you loop back to the beginning again. You left the loop when you realized all you needed to raise your frequency and remove yourself from it. We do not work like this because we understand quantum time and work through frequencies. You do not, so you repeat the same situations, you attract the same situations constantly, until you can break out of the loop. You have realized lately, arguing with family members who do not listen and who think you are crazy, neighbors who are attempting to have sex with you, religious zealots who are attempting to indoctrinate you and add you to their fellowship, codependent females attempting to co-victim with you, and alcoholics attempting to dominate and subjugate you, these represent loops from your past you could enter into, but you are too aware to do so now. So it appears to you that you are unsuccessful again in navigating relationships in this lower dimension, but you are in fact very successful because you have learned these lessons and are aware of what these relationships will do to you. You have avoided the loops. You forge on, observing spacecraft at nighttime, channeling for the public and envisioning our future together. These are not ego loops, they are your soul's purpose you are expressing. I would say you are doing very well with your handling of the third dimensionals around you, and you must stop thinking of yourself as a failure. You have not failed at all. You are not unloving because staying in someone's loop with them is imprisoning both of you in hell. In fact, you are unstoppable. Earthlings' lives have looped over and over and over again. That is why they say, history repeats itself. It does when you do not learn from it. However, it creates a lot of lush for the dark ones, the only ones who gain from your being stuck in a loop. As for this fellow who does not understand my message in the book, do you not see civil war on the horizon? If this is not in your timeline, then perhaps you are of higher frequency and will be spared these consequences. You have alternative realities that are being played out side by side. You are jumping timelines constantly. One day you will experience many messages of horror and doom. Other days you are experiencing messages of lightness and brevity. Other days you are experiencing arrest, with no particular news of much consequence. These are your timelines. When you have missed a juicy tidbit of news, such as Sharon's friend who messaged, asking her to tell her what she knew about what Trump said about the marathon being over, it is because you are working on another area of the collective. This is how timelines work. As you focus on a timeline and send it your light or your fear. You must understand, dear souls, that when you are on the timelines of horror and doom, perhaps you are hearing of fires in Oregon and California, or you are hearing about Portland being razed and BLM riots being carried out. You are on these timelines because you are to influence them. How do you choose to influence them? Do you fear for yourself that perhaps these timelines will overtake your city, or are you sending your love to these cities and peoples of these cities in order to help to raise their frequency and stop the rioting? It is not about what is happening to you, but rather about what you can do to stop it. This is your power. Life does not happen to you, you influence and create life. You are seeing these things for a reason, and the reason is so that you can add your love and light to them. Why do you think the deep state leaves certain events out of the news? Why are some events carried on about and others totally ignored? Because they realize you are generally not telepathic and have no other way of learning of and influencing matters if you do not realize they are happening. Yes. And so you have your own news network among yourselves, which the deep state is in the process of censoring and infiltrating, to keep informed by so that you can continue to send your light to situations you feel you can positively influence. May, like the mass meditations where we send light to help those in need. Ivo, exactly, my love. But you are simply conscious as you read about these events or people in need, such as the children now. You must add your frequency to that part of the collective in order to raise it. If you fear, you send it fear. So do not fear. Your reactions to events is totally of your own choosing, and that is because you are creators. For the man who does not like the messages in our book, what you need to know now, then how do you choose to influence these potential events? And why do you call me out for delivering these messages? You have a saying, don't shoot the messenger, and I am that messenger. Now how do you choose to take responsibility for your part in the collective? How do you choose to influence these situations? Me, thanks, Ivo. Like I said, the onus isn't on me to explain these things to you. It's up to you to decide what you want to do about them. If your choice is to walk away from Sharon and Ivo and ignore the message, then that's your choice. We wish you well. If your choice is to add your love to the collective in order to prevent civil war, then this would be more loving. It's up to you, not me. Folks, like I keep pointing out, I'm starting to work on a completely different footing, one you may not be comfortable with. I don't believe it's my job to explain my book content to you, especially when you send me angry emails, speaking of loops I'd prefer to stay out of. And as Ivo says, it isn't. It's your job to decide what you want to do about it, and if you feel you need to know more, then you go inside to get your personal answers. This is part of the creative process. Daily I find, old ways of thinking are being smashed to reveal what soul has to say to me. Ivo, and as I said, my love, you are being prepared to relate to us, not to be my student, not for me to guide you, but for you to be as we are. Of alien mind, if you wish. Me, thank you Ivo. Ivo, Tianya, you live on a confusing planet and it is difficult to tell what to do with the people around you. However, when the relationship is not based on love and respect, and it is part of the power over others system, then what have you got to gain from it? Nothing. If there is nothing to gain, why would you stay? Yes, to help them. But will they be helped by you? Me, these are tough choices to make. Ivo, but you are being taught to see as we do, my love. We tame domestic animals by making their lives easier for them, we feed them. Guess how the deep state figured out how to tame the earthling? They took us off of the old feudal system, offered us better homes and modernized lifestyles. But we're still their slaves. Feudalism never ended. We still work for them.